everyone, my name is Iris Franz. Today we're going to continue to talk about tax. So in the previous video, we used an analogy of online sales platform to show how it actually doesn't matter whether the government imposes a tax on the buyer or the seller, the result will be exactly the same. And today I'm going to use demand and supply curve to show you graphically why it doesn't matter whether the government imposes a tax on the buyer or the seller. And we're going to look at two cases. The first case is that government tax a buyer, and the second case is the government tax a seller. And you're going to see the result will be exactly the same. So we start with our first case, the government tax the buyer. Now we know before tax, the demand is D1, supply is S1. And their intersection is price P star and the quantity Q star. So you can see without tax, the price paid by the buyer is exactly the price received by the seller because there's no tax. So that price was P star. Now suppose now the government imposed a tax on the buyer. So that's going to shift our demand curve from D1 to D2. And now at the new intersection of the demand and supply curve, you see the price is now PS and the equilibrium quantity is QT. T stands for tax. So on the price tag, the buyer is going to see the price listed as PS, and then you bring this product to the cashier to pay for it. And the cashier is going to show you that the price of the product is PS plus tax, and your grand total will be PV. So PT, that's the on the price tag, plus the tax you pay for the government, and eventually your credit card will be charged PV. So that's when we tax the buyer. Now what happens if the government taxes the seller? So in that case, you can see before tax, our equilibrium price and quantity was P star and Q star, just the same as before. And now the government is going to impose a tax on the seller. So that will shift our supply curve from S1 to S2. And at the new intersection, you're going to see the equilibrium price is now PB and equilibrium quantity is now QT. T stands for tax. So the seller is going to list price PB on the price tag. Now you're the consumer, you see the price PB, and then you go to the cashier, your invoice is exactly PB. And behind the curtain, out of your sin as a consumer, the seller is going to collect PB and pay tax, T dollars, to the government and go home with price PS. So you can see the results are exactly the same. As a consumer, after tax, you pay a price PB. And then the government collect tax T dollars, and the seller goes home with PS. So you don't have to shift supply or demand curve because it doesn't matter whether the government tax the buyer or the seller. You just look at this diagram. When the government is going to collect T dollars of tax, then you find the vertical distance between your demand curve and your supply curve. Exactly T dollars. So like that. And after that, you'll be able to see the price paid by the buyer is higher. We call that PB. And the price received by the seller is PS. And it doesn't matter whether the government taxes the buyer or the seller, the result is the same. That increased the price paid by the buyer, reduced the price received by the seller, and also reduced the equilibrium quantity. So now you ask, who bears more burden of the tax? That really depends on elasticity, and we'll talk about that in the next video. Thanks for watching, and good luck with your studying.